Are you looking for a fun and romantic Valentine's Day date that won't break the bank in Southern California? I'm going to show you four different garden options that could be the perfect place to take your sweetie. Hello and welcome or welcome back to my channel, California Garden Goddess. I'm Anna Harris, and I'm a fourth generation grower living in the beautiful foothills of the Angeles National Forest outside Los Angeles, California. Since today's Valentine's Day, I wanted to do something special for everybody and show you some beautiful botanic gardens that won't break the bank. Stay tuned for the garden that I consider the best in Los Angeles. The first botanic garden is the only garden on the list that has a suggested donation of $5 versus a set admission fee. Fullerton Arboretum is one of my favorites, and it's just a beautiful place to visit because of all the different water features that they have there. Keep in mind that you will have to pay for parking at this location, even though there's no set admission rate, but it's one of the most beautiful places, and you can even find fresh seasonal fruit for sale at the entrance, and you can picnic on the grounds as well. The next garden on my list is also in Orange County, but much closer to the coast. Sherman Library and Gardens is a beautiful place to visit, and it's in Corona del Mar, so it's right by the coast, and you can go for a walk on the beach after visiting the beautiful grounds. Sherman Library and Gardens is a beautiful place to visit and is also one of the only places on the list where you can actually find a restaurant. The library and gardens feature over 100 species of palm tree, and they even have 130 species of begonias. I really enjoy the koi pond and orchid collection, and you're right on the coast. Third on my list is the California Botanic Garden, which is one of the best botanic gardens for seeing native plants in the state. California Botanic Garden is located in Claremont and is close enough to many of you to visit for the day. Last week, I did a feature on the California Botanic Garden, so go ahead and check that video out after this one if you want to learn more about the California Botanic Garden. If you're interested in learning more about California native plants, I highly suggest California Botanic Garden out of all of these four. Some of the other gardens do feature some native plants, but the best source of information for these native plants is California Botanic Garden. If you go to California Botanic Garden, you might be lucky enough to see one of the beautiful male Costa's hummingbirds that I saw on my last visit. You also might see one of these beautiful butterflies just hanging out on a plant. This last botanic garden is also my absolute favorite garden to visit, really anywhere. I've been to Bouchard Gardens in Victoria, British Columbia, which is supposed to be the most beautiful in the world. And while I do love that garden, I love Descanso even more because it's right close by to me. This garden is also the closest to LA. Descanso Gardens in La Canada Flintridge is worth $15 admission price, in my opinion, because it offers something for everybody in the entire family. This is a great place to bring the kids because there's a train for them to go on. You can also picnic outside the grounds. Right now at Descanso, the camellias are blooming and it's absolutely beautiful. You'll see that some people may even make hearts out of the petals on the ground, which is beautiful. I think that these are even more lovely, maybe even they've fallen on the ground, the petals, than when they're on the plant. In certain cases, it's like a shower of petals. It's absolutely perfect for Valentine's Day. I'm planning to visit these gardens on a regular basis to show you what's blooming in the garden at different times of the year. If you're interested in that content, please comment. I'd love to hear from you. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe if you like this content. I'm going to be carrying much more content on California gardens, and I hope to see you around. Catch you in the next video. Bye.